Ellen, welcome and thank you very much for joining us. I was actually chatting with a friend of mine that owns a big car dealership here last week, and he told me that he sold five cars last weekend. I thought, wow, that's five more than I would have thought. What's your estimates for car sales right now? Hard to believe, but apparently still people are buying cars right now.
Yeah, it is pretty amazing, but still we're looking at, you know, an economy and an industry that's really going to be under pressure here. And sales that are, you know, well below the run rate that we saw prior to the onset of this health crisis. So net, it's going to be really tough. You got a lot of cash burn and challenges ahead for the industry.
Yeah, you know, if I go to any Ford, Dodge, GM, all I see is 84 month, 0% financing, no payments for a year, $5,000 cash back, all these promotions. And as hard as things are, we do have to remember there are 130 whatever plus million Americans who are still working, who, if their car isn't working, they'll need to get a car. Do you think we're in some ways we're overstating how bad it could be for the year, or is it just going to be a year to forget?
No, I think, you know, the speed with which this has collapsed is really tough to take. And, you know, one of the areas also is that we're seeing, you know, capital spending plans probably get pushed. You know, the industry was in this transition to move toward electric vehicles. And, you know, we've seen obviously Tesla, but also Rivian and Ford and GM all moving to EVs. And so if that gets delayed, you know, we're going to be at a competitive disadvantage here in the U.S. compared to Europe and China.
Is a $1.50 gasoline and the economic slowdown going to sort of clip the cord for EVs? Or do you believe that that progression will press on regardless?
Yeah, Brian, you know, it's a question of when, not if. The industry is going to move that way. We've got to make sure we take an insurance policy out against climate risks that, you know, we're not really measuring adequately. So I think it's a question of when. And, you know, the Chinese, you probably saw they've extended now their subsidies for EVs for another 2 years. Europe is really marching ahead with CO2 emissions reductions and requirements on the industry. So we can't lose the plot over here. You know, there's 4 million jobs in the auto industry. And then there's another 3 million that depend on those 4 million. So it's a huge industry. And we got to be globally competitive going forward.
Yeah, it is tough. And, you know, listen, if you do believe EVs are the future, I mean, how much does trade-in value matter to the consumer? If I'm going to buy a $50,000 car, plan to drive it for 8 years, but I think in 8 years, EVs are going to be a large portion of our drivability, there's going to be some people that don't want to buy their internal combustion engine car because they're going to be afraid it won't have a lot of value at the end of that lifespan, I would imagine.
You're absolutely right. And, you know, when you look ahead for the government, you know, what if our, you know, vital, cyclically sensitive industries start to encounter, you know, a lot of financial challenges? They're going to need some stimulus. So demand stimulus is going to be a key tool going forward. And consumers are going to hopefully take advantage of that.